Hi everyone and welcome back to the Organized Notebook. In this video, we wanted to cover all about database view options in Notion. And understanding database view options is so crucial for really getting the most use out of Notion and being able to create that perfect Notion workspace. So let's get started. First, let's start by opening an empty Notion page, and you're welcome to follow along as we go through this, and it's probably best to do that so that you really get some hands-on experience. So let's first click on empty page, and we're just going to show you first a table view database. And we'll click table view, and we're going to do plus new database, and we're just going to call this sample database. And just so that we can really customize all of our database view options, we're going to add a few more properties here. So we'll need a date property, and it'll be good to add some tags here. Tag 1, tag 2, tag 3, for example. And let's even add a status. And let's actually just fill some of these in. So once you have some database entries in your sample database, we can get started with the view options. So to access your database view options, you have to go to the three dots and the database here and click it. And then you'll see all of these database view options. So first, we're just going to go from the top. And when you see database view options here, you'll first notice the icon slot here. And here you can basically choose any icon you want from Notion's icon library. So this is very nice if you want to really customize it. And what this is going to do is it's going to reflect on the icon slot on this tab. So let's say we just wanted this to be a home tab. You'll see that it just turned into a house. And you can also customize the name. So you could type home, for example. And next, we're going to cover the layout. And this is one of the most important places you can access. And layout is what changes it into different database views. So we're right now at a table, but you can change this database view into a board view, timeline view, calendar, list, and gallery. And each of these are going to have different toggles here and options on how you can really showcase your data. So in table view, you'll notice that there's the option to either show database title or toggle it off. And so what that does is it's going to remove this title. And we really like to usually toggle this off unless it's going to become really unclear which database we're on, because it just looks cleaner. So if it's on, it's like this. And if it's off, it's like this. And the next thing you can do, especially with table view, is show vertical lines. You can toggle on or off. So if you toggle this off, you kind of get this seamless design without the lines in the middle, and it could look nice depending on what kind of page you're designing. And then we have wrap all columns, and wrap basically means if you have a lot of text here, it's going to show everything if you choose wrap, but if you toggle it off, it's going to save space. So we're just going to show an example. So if we toggle this off, and let's say that we just type more here. So we have a lot, and it's going to hide it. But if we toggle it on, you'll notice that you see everything. So this also depends on what kind of data you're displaying and whether or not it's important for you to see everything at one glance. So let's actually fix this now. And if we go back to the view options, now we are at wrap, and then we also have open pages in. And what this means is that when you click open a database entry, you can choose what kind of opening it does. So if right now it's on side peek, and what that's going to do is it's going to open it on side peek like this. So you can still see the main page here, but you'll see the database page like this on the side. And one thing that it's good to know is that you can actually choose how much you show in the side peaks. So if you only want a little bit, you can do this. If you want more, you can slide it over like this. And the other options are open pages in center peak. And when you do that, if you open, it's just going to show up in the front, and you can click out of it by clicking outside. And then there is open pages and full page. And what this is going to do is it's just going to turn into the other page. And this can sometimes be a little bit hard to use because then you have to go back to this page and you're stuck in the other page. But the other two options give you the opportunity to show both pages at the same time, which is quite useful. And we've basically covered everything here. So now let's see what happens if we click board view. And you'll notice that board view has quite many layout view options. So we have the same show database title or not. And now we have card preview. And what this is going to do is you can choose whether to show the page cover or the page content. So if we did page cover, and let's say that we added a cover page here. And let's just change it to something like a mountain. And if we go back, you'll notice that it shows the cover photo like this. And if we change card preview to page content, what happens is if we type inside here, you'll see the inside of this page. So now you see the inside here. So you can kind of see what kind of use cases you might want with these different card preview options. And with this kind of board style, normally it's quite common to have none so that you can just have all of your properties showing below it. But it's good to know that you can also show different things with the card. And then you can also choose the card size. So right now it's on medium, but you could have small and you could have large, depending on your needs. So if you wanted to click small, maybe you have many of these statuses, so you want to show more, then you might want small. So we're going to keep it to medium. And then we also have the wrap all properties toggle, and we explained what wrap means before. And the most important one is this group by. So to have a board view database, you always have to have a group by. So that means what it's showing this way as. And with group, you can choose what property it's grouped by. So right now it's grouped by status. We could also group by tag and so on. And you can sort it manually, alphabetically, or reverse alphabetically. And you can choose to hide empty groups if you want, or show the empty groups. And then finally, you can decide whether or not to color columns. And this is something that's quite nice if you want a colorful board view. And you can really customize the colors based on this tag. You can change the color of the background. And you can even move these around. You can choose which ones you want to hide manually as well. So there's a lot of flexibility with this board view. And if we go back to board view, we showed group. And then there's also color columns here as well you can use, and the open pages in. And we're just going to put this back to side peek so that we don't keep having to go back to this page. And now let's check out timeline view. So if you click timeline view, you'll see all the options for that. And again, we have show database title, then we have show timeline by and date. And this date option, if you had multiple dates, you can choose which date you're showing the timeline as. But since we only have one date, we just have date. And this is a required property for timeline. And then we have show table. And this is interesting because you can also show the table at the side at the same time. And you can show pretty much everything that you can see on the normal table view. So for example, if you click table properties, you can just toggle all of these on and you basically have the full table on the side. So that could be useful if you need that information there. And then if we go to here, we see that there's also the open pages in options. And now we can check calendar. So if we click calendar, you'll also notice the same toggle here for database title. You can choose which date to show the calendar by. And here you have two options, month view or week view, depending on which type of calendar you want to show. And again, you have the different page open options. And list we have here is one of the most simple ones. So you can choose to show database title or not. And how you're going to open the pages. And then gallery view, we have again database title, and then here we have the card preview options, which we also showed in the board view. And you can choose card size and fit image on or off, and what that means. So let's show page cover, and if you choose fit image, it's going to fit the entire image, and if you toggle it off, it's going to fit the whole cover. And you have the wrap properties and open page options here as well. So let's put this back into table view and let's go out of here. Now let's check the properties inside the database view options. And if we click here, you'll see that it says shown in table, name, tags, date, status. And here's really important because you can really choose which properties are being shown on the outside of this database. And so if we, for example, hide tags, we hide date, and we hide status, you'll notice that it only has name now. And the one thing that you cannot hide is the name or the main database page title. And that makes sense because otherwise you wouldn't know how to even call that database page and it could just get lost. So that's why Notion makes it so that you really cannot hide the name. But you can toggle these on and off depending on how you want to show your data on the outside. But it's even if you hide it, it's still going to be a part of the database entry. So it's not like you're deleting it. It's just that you're hiding it from the view. And you can even reorder them here as well as you wish. And you can also keep track of the properties you've deleted in this garbage area. And you can also add new properties through this place as well. And now let's check what is these filter and sort options. So filter can filter by any of these properties. So if you only wanted to show status, which is not started, you can do that like this, for example. And you have to say for everyone if you want it to be shown for everyone. And if you don't do that, you only see it for yourself. And if we click here, we can reset filters. And then there's also sort. So this is similar as well. You can sort things by alphabetical. You can sort things by date in different directions and so on. And then we have this group by. So right now it's grouped by tags, which means that each of this table view is shown based on tags. So we have tag 1, tag 2, and tag 3. And when we open it, we see the entry which is related to tag 1. So this is pretty useful if you really want to categorize your data based on a property. So we highly recommend grouping when needed. And you can group by pretty much anything. You can group by name, you can group by date or status. And you can do sorting manually, alphabetically or reverse alphabetically. So you can choose the order that this is shown or not, and you can also choose whether to hide empty groups or show empty groups, and you can also choose which groups you really want to see. So let's remove grouping now so we can see the full table. And now what we have is sub items, and for sub items and dependencies, we will do a separate video about this because there's a lot you can do with it, but we'll just show you some basics. So if you go to sub items, you'll see this diagram, and this makes a lot of sense. So you have the parent item and then sub item. So let's say that this database entry is a task and you have certain subtasks that underneath this database entry. Then you could turn this on, and what that does is now you have this arrow and you can press it here and add sub database entry, for example. And this is a really nice way to really keep track of the hierarchy of your tasks or entries or anything. And if we go back here and we go to sub items and we're just going to turn it off, then we also have dependencies, and this also, there can be a lot you can do with this, but the basics is that you basically set dependencies when you want to keep track of what needs to come before the next thing. So this is really useful for tasks in project management because you often have tasks you have to complete before you can go on to the next one. And so when you turn this on, you can really set what task is blocking the next task and so on, and visualize it using timeline view. So we'll cover this in another video. And then we have load limit, and this is a really great thing to know about. So when you click here, you'll notice that there's 10 pages, 25 pages, 50 pages, 100 pages, and what this means is that it has a load limit. So once it reaches 10 pages, it's gonna hide the rest of the entries. So if you had this table and it was full of database entries all the way to the bottom, then you'll have to scroll a lot if you have to put something underneath there, and it's just gonna cover the whole entire page. So we often use 10 pages just to save space on the whole Notion workspace and page, and it's usually nice to do that. And we even wish that Notion would give us more manual options, like 5 pages, for example, and there could be a lot you could do with that. But it's just good to know that you can limit the page number. Otherwise, you could end up with a completely full page just from your table view. So that's load limit. And then there's automations. And this is a relatively new feature, and it's a quite big feature as well. So we're going to cover this in a separate video. But it basically allows you to set different triggers so that when you do something, it's gonna do something else. So if you change something to tag 2, maybe you wanted to automate another property to do something else, for example. So that's automations. And then there's lock database. So lock database, what that does is if you click it, you'll notice it says locked, and now you cannot change the database name. And you cannot add new properties. So it basically locks the database so that you cannot change fundamental things about the database that could really mess things up in other places. So this is especially true if you have relations. And if you just accidentally click the plus button, add a property, it could really throw things off. So it's a good idea to lock the database once you're really sure about your system so you don't misclick anywhere. So this is useful. And then there is copy link to view. And if you do this, you can basically just copy a link to this view of the database. So basically this tab. And then there's duplicate view. And if you click here, you'll notice that we have another tab here. That's a duplicate of the first one. And you can also delete view. And we go back to just this one. So that's the basics of database view options, and as you can see, there's really a lot you can do with it. And the more you master the intricacies of database view options, the more you'll be able to just do with Notion. And we often spend a lot of time just doing various things in this view options area. So it's just something that is so important and fundamental to learning Notion. And we hope that this video was useful for you. And please let us know if there was anything confusing or any questions you have during this video. And we hope to see you in the next one.